is News 3 Now at 10.
And thanks for joining us tonight. We'll have those stories in just a few minutes. But first, we're keeping an eye on the forecast, especially for tomorrow morning, which could bring our first real taste of winter weather. Meteorologist Dana Fulton with our first warm forecast from the Weather Center. Dana.
Eric, we haven't had an inch of measurable snowfall yet this season. And tomorrow morning, it might be that morning for us in Madison. We have an alert day in the forecast, mostly because of the timing. This is going to come through during the morning commute. Visibility will be reduced and the roads will be slippery at times. So please plan ahead. Give yourself plenty of time for that morning commute. We do already have winter weather advisories issued throughout southern Wisconsin. This is for Tuesday morning. As we look at our Doppler track right now, things are pretty quiet for us. Partly cloudy skies for much of southern Wisconsin. The rain and the snow still well to our south, and that's really not going to lift north over the area until we get after midnight. So the snow starts after midnight early Tuesday morning. The drive tomorrow morning is going to be very slippery, but once the snow transitions to rainfall in the afternoon, it will stay rain through the evening and into Wednesday. But we will take a closer look at what is ahead for the rest of the week and some timing with the snow coming through in just a few minutes, Eric.
All right, Dana, thank you. And if you are away from the TV, be sure to download our free Channel 3000 First Warn Weather app for your up-to-date weather information on the go. That includes local forecasts, interactive radar. It's free to download. Just search Channel 3000 in your app store. 18 more people died in Wisconsin today from COVID-19. There are also more than 100 new hospitalizations, more than 3,400 new cases. The 7-day average positivity rate has dropped just below 30% now. Still very high, though, compared to earlier in the pandemic. Thanksgiving could be a low-key affair for most families in Dane County unless the state Supreme Court rules in favor of a conservative law firm. It's helping sue public health over last week's order that bans large gatherings in homes such as sports and group exercise. Amanda Quintana shows us what's at issue and what's at stake.
We're not just fighting the virus, we're fighting the people who are trying to, you know, stop us from enacting guidelines that will keep people safe.
Dane County Executive Joe Parisi says it wasn't a shock to see Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty suing over public health's recent gathering ban. Legal pushback has become routine.
I'd like to see some of these groups spend 5 minutes in one of our local ICUs and witness the devastation this virus has brought on our community.
Parisi says Emergency Order 10 is designed to help hospitals, which are overwhelmed with COVID patients. Will's attorney says his clients take COVID seriously, but they feel the county's approach is wrong.
The fact that the Dane County Health Officer has basically been ruling by decree for 8 months now is inappropriate, and we think unconstitutional, actually.
Luke Berg, deputy counsel for the group Will, argues public health doesn't have the authority to create this order.
These big types of policy decisions need to be made by the elected governing body.
A similar argument blocked the state's Safer at Home order this spring. But even if the county board would have taken the steps to pass this order, Berg thinks it still goes too far.
The order allows a 1,000-square-foot coffee shop to stay open, but basically shuts down a 20,000-square-foot gymnasium. There's no reason a business like that can't operate safely.
Parisi thinks it doesn't go far enough. He says without statewide restrictions and similar rules in neighboring counties, COVID keeps spreading. He's blaming lawsuits like this one for creating confusion and divisiveness.
They can strike down our rules, but that's not going to stop the virus. That's only going to make it worse.
Amanda Quintana, News 3 Now.
Parisi says he believes most people in Dane County understand why the guidelines are in place and support them. But if lawsuits like this one are successful, we'll see even more deaths, he says. Starting today, Hy-Vee has reinstated a reserved shopping hour for high-risk customers in response to the recent increase in cases. According to a release, the hour will be at all Hy-Vee locations, 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. That's Monday through Friday. Customers able to shop in that period are those older than 60, expectant mothers, and anyone with an underlying health condition. A third vaccine to prevent coronavirus could be available as early as next month. This one is produced in the United Kingdom by Oxford University through drug maker AstraZeneca. Large-scale trials, some conducted by UW Health, show this third vaccine is more than 70% effective. That number may jump as high as 90% when they tweak the dosage. But doctors with UW Health say more testing needs to be done, specifically here in the United States, in order to get approval for distribution.
I think that we have to be a little bit tempered on this news because the data that was released today from AstraZeneca came from outside of the United States. The trials are ongoing in the United States, and that data hasn't been opened yet, so we don't know what it shows.
Dr. Hartman says there are about 10,000 participants in the U.S. so far, and the FDA requires at least 30,000. Unlike the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines, which require deep freezing, the UK vaccine can be stored in the fridge. Researchers say it's also cheaper to produce and faster to roll out once it receives regulatory approval. U.S. airports saw more travelers this weekend than has been reported since the start of the pandemic, even as health experts urge Americans to stay home this holiday. Just yesterday, more than 1 million people were screened at U.S. airports, the highest number of passengers reported in a single day since back in the middle of March. The Packers organization today says it will be hosting some fans during this weekend's game against the Chicago Bears, while Lambeau Field is still closed on game days to ticketed fans. Sunday's game will host a small group of Packers employees and their households in the stadium. The team is hopeful that hosting ticketed fans will be possible in the coming weeks, so the small group of about 500 fans will be part of the process of evaluating enhanced protocols for fan attendance. And the Milwaukee Bucks today announcing there will not be any fans allowed at Fiserv Forum, at least for the time being. The NBA season will start a little later this year than normal, December 22nd. Bucks officials say they'll continue to work with local health officials as well as the NBA to evaluate a potential return for fans in some capacity once the season gets underway. Developing tonight, a total of 3 people have now been arrested in connection with the shooting that happened on Friday at Mayfair Mall in Wauwatosa. Included in those 3 arrests is the alleged 15-year-old shooter. 8 people were injured during the shooting. All are expected to survive. The new arrests we're learning about tonight are the passenger in the vehicle at the time of the suspected shooter's arrest, and also another person believed to be involved. Police have speculated that the shooting was not a random act, but came in the wake of a, quote, altercation. One person died in a crash in Sun Prairie earlier this afternoon. This was on Main Street about 3:30 near Whitetail Drive between Pick and Save and Uplands Park. The road reopened about 8:30 tonight. According to police, 2 cars and 2 pedestrians were involved in the crash. Multiple people were injured. Police are still investigating what led to that incident.
We transported 2 to the hospital. And unfortunately, we did have 1 deceased on scene. So right now, we're doing a police investigation just to kind of figure out exactly how this occurred. Obviously, with a fatality, we want to make sure that we're taking a very, very close look at exactly, what happened.
Kenosha County prosecutors are asking for a hearing on a California attorney's request to be allowed to represent Kyle Rittenhouse. Attorney John Pierce isn't licensed to practice in Wisconsin, so he'd need the court's permission to represent the teenager. Requests like this are routinely granted, but prosecutors want a hearing on this matter. The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel is reporting Pierce has no real criminal defense experience and has been promoting Rittenhouse as a patriot. Wisconsin Attorney General Josh Call has filed a lawsuit challenging parts of a Republican-authored law limiting his power that were passed during a lame duck legislative session 2 years ago. Now, the suit targets parts of the law requiring the State Department of Justice that Call runs to get approval from the legislature's budget committee before settling certain lawsuits. Day 4 of the recount process in Dane County has now come to an end. Coming into this day, the Dane County Board of Canvassers made it through about a quarter of the ballots. Today, they focused on some of the larger around Madison, like Monona, Verona, Stoughton, and Sun Prairie. And County Clerk Scott McDonald says they'll be starting on City of Madison ballots in the next day or so. It's very likely they won't finish until after Thanksgiving on the recount. However, he thinks they will be able to take the holiday off. The Trump administration has finally agreed to begin the transition to President-elect Joe Biden. That announcement came after Michigan certified election results today, confirming Joe Biden's win in the state. Natalie Brand reports from the White House.
The General Services Administration has ascertained Joe Biden is the apparent winner of the 2020 election, meaning the formal transition process can begin. In a letter to the president-elect, GSA Administrator Emily Murphy formally offered to begin coordinating a transfer of power. This follows a standoff that started more than 2 weeks ago after CBS News and other media organizations projected Biden as the winner.
Van Langfeld.
Yes.
The decision came hours after Michigan certified Biden's victory and 2 days after a judge dismissed a Trump campaign lawsuit aimed at stopping Pennsylvania's certification. On Twitter, President Trump thanked Murphy and recommended that she and her staff do what needs to be done.
On Twitter, President Trump indicated he supports the GSA's decision, but he's still not conceding. The president says his fight continues, and he says he believes he will prevail.
President-elect Biden was already moving forward with the transition, naming key cabinet picks today. He's chosen Tony Blinken to be nominated for Secretary of State, Jake Sullivan as National Security Advisor, and Linda Thomas-Greenfield to be nominated as the next U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations. If confirmed, Alejandro Mayorkas would be the first Latino American and immigrant Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security, while Avril Haines has been tapped to become the first woman nominated for Director of National Intelligence.
Why'd you go with National Security first?
There are reports President-elect Biden is expected to nominate former Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen as his Treasury Secretary. Natalie Brand, CBS News, The White House.
The head of the Biden transition team called the GSA's move a, quote, needed step to begin tackling the challenges facing our nation, including getting the pandemic under control and our economy back on track. And President-elect Biden's pick for the next U.S. ambassador to the United Nations is a UW-Madison alumna. That would be Linda Thomas-Greenfield, who earned her master's degree in public administration from the UW back in 1975 and has worked with the Young African Leaders Initiative on campus. She has worked for the State Department for more than three decades now. Still to come tonight, an update on the snow chances tomorrow morning, plus a couple of former Milwaukee Bucks getting the opportunity to meet the Pope today. We'll have that story when we come back.
Since 1902, Carrier has been inventing new ways to make people comfortable. And today, comfort can also mean efficiency. Because being more efficient with your home heating can mean spending less on it. And that's something everyone can get comfortable with. If you're ready for Carrier comfort, now you can get cool cash rebates of up to $1,650 on a new system. Carrier, turn to the experts.
Kurt Schlickow Heating and Cooling, serving Sauk County and surrounding areas.
Paul Greiber Heating and Sheet Metal in Wanakee, serving all of Dane County.
Imagine life in that, that, or that. Having zero stress. Wasting zero energy worrying. 0 days wanting less seats, more seats, and zero regrets. Imagine that. Zero reasons not to get into a Volkswagen, especially now that you can start shopping from home. Click, call, or come by today. Visit our Volkswagen Sign and Drive event and lease the 2020 T1 S4 Motion today with zero down, zero deposit, zero first month's payment, and zero to its signing.
No cell phones at the table.
But it's Grandma.
Hi, Mom.
It's time to cozy up and have fun. Go ahead, give your home those new items you're craving for a comfy new feel. The time is right. It's Slumberland's biggest Thanksgiving sale in 3 years. You'll get an additional 25% off our already low prices. Get your look for less at the Thanksgiving sale at Slumberland.
Bye, Grandma.
Bye, Grandma.
When I grow up, I want to be an expert in something. I want to know what it would be like to make a difference. I want to be a part of something bigger, to help people, to change lives. When I grow up, I want to show the world that anything is possible. But now I know that making a difference doesn't take much.
It just takes me. Join our team. Unity Point Health Meritor, a partner of UW Health, know how much you matter to this world.
Seeing the joy that people feel when they share a meal with family and friends, that's why we do this. The laughter of kids around the table, the thrill of families driving through for a treat, the delight of not having to cook, and instead letting us safely serve you. It all comes back to taking care of each other. And for that, we'll be here with your favorites and always a smile.
Tuesday morning is an alert day.
We'll have team coverage of the weather headed our way and live looks at how the snow is affecting the commute.
We'll see you from 4:30 to 7 Tuesday morning.
You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
First, First Lady Melania Trump welcomed the official White House Christmas tree today. The tradition, dating to 1966, includes a horse-drawn carriage bringing the tree to the North Portico at the White House. This year's tree comes from West Virginia. It'll be displayed in the historic Blue Room of the White House. All Smithsonian Institution museums are closed now, closed again due to a spike in cases. The organization says it's also closing the National Zoo. Smithsonian first closed all of its locations in March, but reopened in September with some limitations. Now the institution says it's changing course to prioritize the health of staff and also visitors. General Motors recalling 7 million pickups and SUVs worldwide with Takata airbags. National Highway Traffic Safety Administration ordered a U.S. recall today, rejecting GM's argument that this version of the airbags didn't need to be replaced. That decision comes more than 6 years after initial recalls linked to Takata airbags started back in 2014, ultimately becoming the largest auto recall in history. Now, this latest recall covers the Cadillac Escalade, the Chevrolet Avalanche, the Silverado, the Suburban, the Tahoe, also the GMC Sierra and Yukon model years 2007 to 2014. Several NBA players met with Pope Francis. This was at the Vatican today to discuss their efforts to address social and economic injustice. After the Vatican reached out to the players' union to learn about their work for social change, a delegation that included Sterling Brown and Kyle Korver traveled to meet the Pope. Images from the meeting showed Pope Francis and the players sitting, standing next to each other, not wearing masks, but a Players Association member says everyone who attended was required to undergo testing beforehand. Now, Major League Baseball today setting a tentative date for the Field of Dreams game, that game featuring the White Sox and Yankees. It'll mark the first ever Major League game to be played in the state of Iowa. It was originally set to be played this past summer, of course, but postponed by the pandemic. It's now set for August 12th of 2021. MLB built a temporary ballpark in Dyersville. That's near the site where the iconic 1990 movie Field of Dreams was filmed. The Dane County Farmers Market has a new plan to help residents stay safe and warm while supporting local vendors this winter. Starting next week on Wednesday, local food pickups will move from Willow Island to inside a pavilion at the Alliant Energy Center. Shoppers can order locally grown vegetables as well as meats, cheeses, specialty items, and you don't even have to leave your car to get them pick them up. Pickups are on Wednesdays, December 2nd, 9th, 16th, from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. You can place your pre-order through an app called What's Good. There are directions about how to order on the Dane County Farmers Market website, dcfm.org. All right, we've got some snowy weather coming our way. Here it comes, our first dose, your first warm forecast. Here's Dana.
This is likely, again, going to be our first chance to pick up an inch of accumulation this season. We've already seen a few opportunities where we picked up about 3/4 of an inch, a little over 1/4 of an inch. And tomorrow, I think we're going to pick up a little bit more in the morning. Because it's coming down during our morning commute, please make sure you give yourself extra time on the roads. That light snow might mix with a little light rain at times, making things a bit slushy outside. Overall, today, we got to enjoy the sunshine. Still partly cloudy outside, but the system off to the west is starting to approach and drive shower chances throughout the plains and Midwest. Right now, we're seeing some of that rain form along the eastern and southern edge of Iowa and into central Illinois. We're expecting mostly rain to our south, but for southern Wisconsin on north, we are going to see light snowfall starting after midnight and continuing through tomorrow morning before that warmer air builds in and all of that light snow transitions over to light rain. So right now we are still partly cloudy. It's still dry outside. If you've left anything out overnight that you didn't want to get wet, if your blaze orange is out drying right now, you might want to bring that inside because we are in for a snowy and then very soggy setup for the next few days. Becoming mostly cloudy as we get closer to midnight. Temperatures are going to hold pretty steady, close to 30 degrees as it is going to be cloudy outside. The light snow chances mixing with a bit of rain at times builds in, and that's going to continue throughout the morning commute hours. So 7, 8, 9 o'clock, we still have light snow coming down. Temperature wise though, notice we're in the mid to low 30s, so it's going to be that heavy dense snow. Visibility likely reduced at times, also a little windy outside. That continues into the late morning, and that's when we start to transition over to some light rain. Once we transition over to light rain, it will stay light rain through the afternoon and evening as high temperatures will be climbing close to 40 degrees. We'll stay close to 40 through much of the evening, not dropping much overnight. So by early Wednesday morning, temperatures are in the upper 30s and we'll have more shower chances passing through during the day on Wednesday. Wednesday will stay mostly cloudy. We're back to sunshine though by Thanksgiving Day, and we'll be drying out for Thanksgiving and heading into the weekend. Snowfall totals anywhere from 1 to 4 inches expected, with these higher amounts mainly off to the west, and could see a little higher accumulations to the south. Janesville and Monroe included in that. Much of downtown Madison going to be seeing this during rush hour. So that's why our alert day is in the forecast, because mostly the timing. It's going to be messy outside early in the morning. The snow comes down pretty quickly early on, and then we transition over to rain. Not concerned about having to clean up much of that later on in the day, as the rain will melt it away. But early in the morning, you'll probably need the brush to clean off your vehicle, the windows, your mirrors, and of course the top coming through. Our alert day tomorrow is accompanied with that winter weather advisory for most of southern Wisconsin. Much of that goes into effect at midnight and then continues through Tuesday morning, because the slippery roads are expected during our morning commute. Breezy and chilly outside and a little wet. We'll have snow early in the day and then showers expected, rain showers expected in the afternoon and evening. Wednesday we'll see temperatures in the low 40s with showers. We're in the upper 40s on Thursday for Thanksgiving, and then Friday partly sunny in the mid 40s. We'll stay in the mid 40s for the weekend, with dry conditions expected for both Saturday and Sunday. And as we head into the following week, we'll get a bit cooler outside. High temperatures will be in the 30s, with those overnight lows dropping down into the 20s. So I hope you have the snow boots on hand, Eric, just because it's going to be soggy outside. I know it won't be thick early on, but it's going to be wet.
We got to be ready. Here it comes.
It's on the way.
Yep. All right. Thank you very much, Dana. Just ahead in sports, the Badger men back on the ice tonight. How they lit the lamp at will. Skated past Penn State. Zach has sports next.
Now, First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Dear Wallet, Toyota Black Friday is revving up. Packing the action and packing the deals. Yours, Toyota. Get 1.9% APR for 60 months plus $500 APR bonus cash on a new Highlander or Highlander Hybrid. Toyota, let's go places.
Real customers are experiencing a real difference with Spectrum Internet and TV.
The speed is insane. It's always right there. Just boom.
It was easy to connect all of my devices, and I was able to find a plan that was affordable for me.
I'm saving money, and I'm even getting more speed.
Get the speed you need to do all the things you love on all your devices with Spectrum Internet, delivering the fastest starting speeds for the price. 200 megabits. Switch now for $44.99 a month. Call 833-918-4499.
With Spectrum TV, the picture quality is incredible. I feel like I'm in the movie.
The amount of stuff available on Spectrum On Demand is just never ending.
Add Spectrum TV and enjoy more free HD and more free on demand. Plus, use the Spectrum TV app to watch live TV on the go. All from $44.99 a month. Call 833-918-4499.
Spectrum gives me the best deal no matter what.
Every day I'm saving money.
Get Spectrum Internet and TV from $44.99 a month each with no contracts. Ask about our easy self-install options to install your new services yourself. Call 833-918-4499.
You know what I think? I think you owe us $48.50. Wild thing.
If you ride, you get it. Geico Motorcycle. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Hey, Dutch boy, show me Mocha Red.
Okay.
Does it have a smooth, durable finish?
Yes, and it's 50% more stain resistant.
Still talking to Dutch boy?
Dutch boy, show me Sleepy Purple.
Okay.
Oh, would you look at that.
That's better.
He'll still help us paint, right?
With Dutch Boy's quality paint and Menards expert service, you can twist off to something great.
Right now at Menards, get 11% off everything, including Dutch Boy paint.
Wisconsin is a home of workers. We know what needs to get done, and we do it. Yet, we've been hit hard, some harder than others. Our contact may be limited, but we still can lift each other up. The Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund and your local energy providers are working together to help keep your heat and power on. You may not ask for it, but we want you to know we're here.
Dear Wallet, Toyota Black Friday is revving up. Packing the action and packing the deals. Yours, Toyota. Get 1.9% APR for 60 months plus $500 APR bonus cash on a new Highlander or Highlander Hybrid. Toyota, let's go places.
The Wisconsin men's hockey team back in action tonight, and so was their crazy schedule. 5 o'clock puck drop on Monday night against Penn State, and remember, it's their third game in 5 days. Robbie Badun between the pipes for the Badgers, and he was standing on his head. The dude saved 49 shots tonight. The Badgers only took 20, but they made them count. Sam Stang goes top shelf to put UW up 3-1 in the second. Stang lit the lamp twice. And then in the third, the Caulfield brothers took over. First, Brock slides in and taps home the puck. Then later, Badgers on the power play and Cole doing his thing. The quick wrister is his first of the year. Badgers win 6-3.
You don't over critique a win too much from the standpoint, we grinded it out. The bottom line is, like I said, when we started, you know, everything's not going to be perfect when you don't have your legs. And when that happens, you got to find a way. And again, you do it with goaltending. You do it by being smart and disciplined.
The battle for Paul Bunyan's axe might get the axe due to COVID-19. Minnesota had 20 players out last week and won't practice tomorrow because of possibly more positive tests. As of now, game's still on and the Gophers plan on practicing on Wednesday. But this week for Graham Mertz, a little different. You see, his dad, Ron, was an offensive lineman for the Gophers in the late 80s, early 90s. So the battle for the axe is also for family bragging rights in the Mertz household.
He's funny because I'm like, Dad, we got your boys this week. And he's like, all right, easy with that. Like, you're my boy now. So it's definitely funny, but it's, I don't really know. I don't know what he's thinking, but I know he likes the Badgers right now. So he's a fan of wherever the Mertzes are playing.
The Badger men's basketball team begins their journey for another Big Ten championship Wednesday when they tip off their season against Eastern Illinois. And game day is long overdue. Wisconsin last played on March 7th. Since then, it's just been playing against each other. And after a while, practice can get old and the Badgers, well, they're sick of each other.
I think they're tired of seeing each other. We've had a few more scuffles lately in practice that are probably for the norm, just because we've gone against each other and competed with each other for so long.
I had dreams about it, how it's going to be different. I've really put some thought into how the crowd is not going to be there. It's going to be different to be in an empty arena. And honestly, to me, it will feel more like a scrimmage.
That's it for sports. We'll be right back.
This year, our driveways have brought us all closer together and been our gateways to the world. For over 30 years, Lexus has been celebrating driveway moments in a year filled with memorable ones. Here's to one more. The Lexus December to Remember sales event.
Lease the 2021 RX350 all-wheel drive for $419 a month for 36 months and we'll make your first month's payment.
Experience amazing.
Protect what's important to you from COVID-19. You help protect everyone in Wisconsin. Learn how you can stop the spread at dhs.wisconsin.gov/COVID-19.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we always offer genuine values on the things you need. But this year, our Black Friday bargains are coming early with incredible pre-Black Friday deals available now throughout the store. Like these special buy kitchen tool or knife block sets half off. Get $50 off this Milwaukee 5-tool combo kit. And this Laren floor jack and creeper kit is half off. Plus, buy online and pick up your items in our convenient drive-thru. You don't even need to get out of your car.
Find value at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Are you ready to tone? Well, let's warm up those muscles.
Get your
chia in shape with Richard Simmons Chia Pet and your favorite painter, Bob Ross Chia Pet.
Fantastic.
Just spread the seeds, water, and watch it grow.
Chia.
And the Trolls Poppy Chia Pet. And don't forget the adorable hedgehog and llama chia pets.
Chia. Always make you happy.
Chia Pets, the gift that grows.
At Walgreens, Lowe's, Menards, and Target. Makes a great gift.
I love to equal the playing field. I love to help people and allow them to feel like they are powerful instead of powerless. We're with our clients every step of the way.
Gingras Thompson and Walks.
At News 3 Now, the FCC allowed us to boost the power of our broadcast signal. If you watch us using an antenna, you may need to activate the scan function on your TV menu to rescan available channels so you can continue to enjoy News 3 Now and CBS programming. Please rescan your TVs today.
Download the Channel 3000 First Warn Weather app today.
You're watching News 3 Now at 10.
Finally tonight, Madison has been ranked the number one best place to retire, according to a new Money.com poll. Money looked at 47,000 data points to determine the list. They also looked at housing, climate, diversity, and safety. According to Money, Madison was selected as number one because of its recreational activities, natural beauty. Money also cited free events, restaurants, and the Dane County Farmers Market as perks of living in the area. And I know it said climate on that list, Dana, but tomorrow morning we may be thinking about far off places that are a little warmer.
Oh no, the best part about living in Wisconsin is getting all four seasons. That's what we're transitioning into right now. We will have light snow in the morning, that turns to rain in the afternoon. A little rain expected on Wednesday. Then we're back to sunshine for Thanksgiving Day Thursday. It continues into the weekend, cooler for the following week.
All right, Dana, thank you. Thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 10. Have a good night.